still. And lo and behold, the next page I opened to was 488. And I was thunderstruck when I read that arriving from Sussex County, Delaware, in 1858, Jacob Bloxon, George Allegood, Jim Allegood, and George Lewis, they arrived and he told their story to William Still.
The author, William Still, was one of the most tireless workers on the Underground Railroad. Nearly forgotten today, between 1840 and 1861, Still and his family harbored more than 2,700 runaway slaves at their home in Philadelphia. Working with whites and free blacks from Florida to Canada, Still developed a loose network of friends who would assist fugitive slaves by foot, cart, and ship. He kept rare day-by-day records of his activities. He wrote down the personal narratives of hundreds of fugitive slaves. He copied out letters for runaways who were trying to get word to wives and children left behind. And he then arranged to have those letters smuggled to the South.
Dear wife, I now inform you I am in Canada and am well, and hope you are the same, and wish you to be here next August. I am doing well working for a butcher, and will get good wages in the spring. I now get $2.50 a week. I expect you, my wife Leanne, and our sons Alexander and Lewis and Ames will all be here soon, and Isabella also. If you can't bring all, bring Alexander surely. Write when you
will
come.
You will come and I will meet you in Albany. Love to you from your loving husband, Jacob. So this is my family, documented by William Still. I felt like a bolt of lightning just struck me. You know, I couldn't move. I was broke out in sweat because here, documented in this book, this classic, was James Bloxon, and later he talks about Jim Bloxon, the same James Bloxon that my grandfather, his father, was singing about, and I at the age of 10 years old. It was like deja vu. All that went around came around.
He was a first person participant. His contribution to our knowledge is enormous. And he put down names, he put down masters' names. It's an incredible body of material.
And William Still's personal story is no less remarkable. William was a freeborn black, but his mother, Charity, was an escaped slave. Before William was born, Charity worked on a Maryland plantation and had two sons, Peter and Levin.
She tries to escape with her children. She fails. She is brought back. And after a long time, she determines that she's got to escape. But this time, she makes the decision to escape and leave her children behind. Can you imagine what a decision that is for a mother to make? So she strikes out. She leaves her children with her mother, who is also a slave on the same plantation.
And Peter, being only six, he was crying for his mama. Granny, I want my mama. Well, Peter, there's a place not far from here called Philadelphia. Can you say Philadelphia, Peter? I could say Philadelphia, Granny. Well, Peter, when you get down there, where they taking you? Mayhap you find a white man you could trust, and you tell them you got stole from your mama from a place called Philadelphia.
In a paroxysm of rage, Charity's master took the two boys away from their grandmother and sold them to another slaveholder in Mississippi, literally selling Peter and Levin down the river. 30 years later, a man, frightened and weary, walks into William Still's office at the Pennsylvania Anti-Slavery Society in Philadelphia. He's looking for his mama. Her name is Charity. His name is Peter. Later, William Still would write of this amazing reunion. After traveling 1,600 miles, almost the first man whom Peter sought advice from was his own brother, whom he had never seen or heard of. He was my long-lost brother, whose history and fate had been enveloped in sadness so long, and for whom mother had shed so many tears. Peter and William hatched a plan to rescue Peter's wife and children, still enslaved. During the daring rescue attempt, one of Still's compatriots, a white conductor named Seth Conklin, was killed, and Peter and his family were all returned to slavery.
Letter to slave master B. McKiernan from William Still. Now, sir, allow me to make an appeal to your humanity. Although we are aware of your power to hold as property those poor slaves, your present humble correspondent is the youngest of Peter's brothers and the first one he saw in arriving in this part of the country. As regards the price fixed upon by you for the family, I must say I do not think it is possible to raise half that amount. But, sir, will the money be as great a benefit to you as the satisfaction you will find in bestowing so great a favor upon those whose entire happiness in this life depends upon your decision in the matter? Your obedient servant, William Still, August 1851.
No reply to this letter was ever received from Master McKiernan. It was an Underground Railroad fairy tale, without the part where they live happily ever after. This is the real Underground Railroad, a mammoth, dangerous struggle for freedom that failed as often as it succeeded. But the passengers and the conductors along the line were undaunted. They persevered and began to come up with ingenious escape plans, desperate measures called for by desperate times.